For the A5, know what causes brake pull during braking and after brakes are released. Brake lines and hoses can develop internal restrictions over time. The main focus of brake pull is on the front wheels. Let's say the driver's side brake hose is partially blocked off internally. In this scenario, hydraulic pressure would still apply the brakes, but when brakes are released, the fluid would be slow to move back due to the restriction. This means the brakes stay applied for some time after the brake pedal has been released. This creates brake drag and a pull to that side of the vehicle. In another scenario, let's pretend that the driver's side brake hose is completely blocked off. When the brake pedal is depressed, these brakes will not activate. Only the passenger side brakes are going to be biting. So your pull will be towards the opposite side, towards the passenger side during braking. Do you guys get that? It is imperative that you understand this concept of brake pull and brake drag. Make a note that worn suspension components can cause the same pull during braking and after braking. If the caliper piston was seized on the driver's side, which way would the vehicle pull? The answer depends on which position the caliper piston is seized in. If it was seized in the at-rest position, the brakes would not apply on the driver's side, so the pull would be towards the passenger side during braking. If the piston was seized in the applied position, the brakes would drag after brakes are released and the pull to the driver's side. But what about the other caliper parts? A seized slide pin in the rest position or a seized caliper in the rest position are the same thing as a seized piston in the at-rest position. The brakes will not activate on this side and the pull will be towards the opposite side. But if they're seized in the applied position, then the brakes would drag on the driver's side and the pull will be towards the driver's side. And we can't forget about the square cut seal. If it was binding and not retracting the piston, you could figure what would happen with brake drag and brake pull. Now vocab, seized can mean the same thing as stuck or binding. One thing to look out for is the use of the word restriction. In some practice tests I've done, it meant partially blocked off, and in some others, it meant completely blocked off. And as we've seen, these two descriptions have two very different symptoms. Here's a brake pull and drag in action. If a component is seized on the left side, that side will not activate. So when I hit the brakes, the pull is towards the right. If a component is dragging on the left side, after the brakes are released, the pull will be towards the left side. Interesting. For drum brakes, the focus is on the causes of brake drag. Since drum brakes are on the back of the vehicle, brake pull is not as noticeable. So in theory, there is pull, but focus more on brake drag. A seized or broken return spring causes brake drag because the spring does not return the brake shoes to the at-rest position. A seized parking brake is obvious. The parking brake will not let go and the brake shoes will drag. Similarly, if the parking brake is adjusted too tight or if the brake shoes are adjusted too tight. There's more causes of brake drag due to a faulty master cylinder, but that'll be in video number 2. I'll end the video with 3 questions about brake drag and brake pull that I expect to see on the actual test. And number 3, which of the following will most likely cause brake pull when faulty? A, a master cylinder. B, metering valve. C, drum brake self-adjuster. Or D, the brake caliper. See ya in video number 2.